Hello everyone, welcome to FinDataSea. Please like and subscribe our channels below. Your support means a lot to us and is well appreciated. Last lesson, we went through part 1 to explain in details the two API functions, getStockFilter and SetPriceReminder. In today's lesson, we're going to part 2 to run the code in real time. This time, we will use Jupyter Notebook. You may also use other Python interfaces such as Spider, PyCharm, VS Code, etc. First step is to open our API program in the background. If you do not know how to do it, please refer to our first video, Introduction of Moomoo API. Before running Moomoo API under the Python environment for the first time, we need to pip install the package. Afterwards, we can import the module using from. Here we put a star in there, so we import everything under the module. Now let's go through an example of the getStockFilter function. In this example, we did a simple filter of all Hong Kong listed stocks if their amplitude is between 30% and 40%. Amplitude is the difference between a stock's highest price and the lowest price. A fluctuating stock is likely to have a higher amplitude. Every time we interact with the API, we need to first set up a connection with the Moomoo server. First line here is to initiate a connection with the Moomoo server. Recall we have three filter types to choose from: simple, accumulate, and financial filter. In today's example, we're going to use accumulate filter. First, we will assign accumulate filter to the variable we created, also named accumulate filter. Next, we will assign the filter amplitude here. If we press tab here, we'll see other options available under the simple filter. Next, for minimum and maximum, we set the minimum amplitude to be 30% and maximum to be 40%. For the parameter of is no filter, we will always set it to false. For sort, we'll sort the orders in ascending. Now we have set all parameters for the accumulate filter. Let's go into the function getStockFilter. The first parameter in the function is market. Here we choose Hong Kong, so we can only select Hong Kong market in the filter. Next parameter accumulate filter will refer back to the parameters we set above. We have created a variable called our stock list to store all the stock codes. And then a simple for loop to save all the results into the our stock list variable. Let's run the code. Here is the result of our filter. We found 4 Hong Kong stocks with amplitude between 30% and 40%. Now we have our favorite stocks. Let's set a reminder using the SetPriceReminder function. Quickly switch to the Moomoo PC software. Click the top left corner, the reminder window will show up. Now we have nothing in the reminders. Let's go back to our code. The first section is an error message in case something goes wrong. The next line quote CTX, as explained earlier, is to initiate connection with the Moomoo API. Let's take a look at the SetPriceReminder function. Here we use a for loop to run through the variables, which is the stock list from our filter earlier. Let's go through the parameters inside the function. Code is the stock code. Operation equals to add, so we're adding a new stock reminder. By pressing Tab, we can see all the options here, such as Delete and Modify. Next, Reminder Type. This should match our filter criteria. Since we used Amplitude to filter, it's only natural here our reminder should be Amplitude as well. Therefore, we use Change Rate Up to set the reminder if the price goes up by a percentage. And for the percentage, we choose 5, which is 5%. Reminder frequency we set to always, so every time the price goes up by 5%, we get a notification. Let's run the code. After running the code, now we can see all the reminders pop up in our alerts window. Next, we'll teach you how to remove all the reminders. Here, we still use the same function setPrice Reminder. But for the parameter OP, instead of add, we'll use delete all to remove all the reminders we have. Let's run the code. Let's switch back to the Moomoo PC program. We can see all the reminders are gone. This concludes for today's lesson. In part 1 video, we showed how to subscribe the API data and went through the format of the two API functions used for stock filter and stock reminder. In part 2 video today, we put the functions into practice and filtered the stocks based on amplitude and set reminder if the price goes up by 5%. Thank you for watching. If our video helped you, make sure to like and subscribe below. Your support is essential to our next production. Have a fantastic day.